Hello everybody, my name is Tokriva and welcome back to Europa Universalis 4, playing Conquest of Paradise on a random new world map as Great Britain now. Yay, we became Great Britain. Still this Declaration of Indulgences, I don't want this one really, because heretics. I want it once we are actually reformed into either Protestantism or Reformation. That's when I would like to change that. We are waiting to build a dry dock, and what I noticed when I started this new episode, before I just started this episode, the personal union will continue once again when the King of Denmark dies. Ugh. Not good. Embargoed by Sweden. So what I am going to do is dissolve the alliance with Denmark, even though we are improving relations with Denmark. The thing is, their navy is also not up to snuff compared to ours. 30, they don't even have any heavy ships, so they do have 14 galleys, and those are not weak. Our colony is self-sustaining. Nice. Go to. Excellent. There we go. So the 13 colonies have been founded. And I'm going to keep this name because that's a little bit nicer. We have one colonist available, so I'm going to send it into Saskatchewan and continue our expansion there. This also means that this... Yeah, I'm not sure if I want to expand more than two at a time right now, especially if I'm also going to expand in Africa. But, you know... Yeah, and besides, Mohawk still needs to grow a lot. You know what? I'm going to split him up, send one into the one group. And the other one is just going to go up north. So now we have two colonial subjects. Oh, great. Trying to keep the Pope. So Great Britain, it's colonial subjects. Very nice. Still the same things here. Free advisor slot. Yeah, I first want to start building that dry dock. Home from Denmark, okay. Colonist 0% still, because it doesn't get the bonus chance, really. Okay, grateful natives and Mohawk, because our new guy did not even arrive yet. No, they did arrive. No decisions, but now let's see how much income we get from both of them. Okay, 13 colonies is at also the same, but we're going to increase tariffs with them, definitely. Increasing it once will increase it by 3%, so we can also go to... Let's equalize the taxation of Newfoundland and the 13 colonies now, shall we? Following amount of trade power, enlisted nodes, nice. 1.3 each month, they will be... Great Army Dance Overlord will feel more inclined towards rebellion. Okay. Sorted by army size. Yeah, that's the... When it goes up, your... trade know their liberty desire, they get a modifier in which their force limits increases, or their manpower. No, their manpower will increase, or both. I'm actually not sure. So a dry dock in London. Okay, that's Mohawk. Let's combine you two again. So yeah, they will have double coastal access, by the way. It's going to be fun to hooking up with the natives, and then they will go to a war with them as well. Newfoundland still improving relations. That will be very high relations. And now 9.72, but of course we are lacking one colony at the moment. Denmark. If I declared war on Norway, we do not have any allies right now. Okay, I want Sweden as an ally, because they might actually join us in that war. So I'm going to also increase relations with them. Okay, Danish relations, you can come back. Frobisher is still in Gelre, which I don't mind at all. One more month, and then we can get this guy. More military tech. Home from Denmark. Push it in again. Home from Sweden. Okay, Sweden, we can definitely increase our relations once again. There we go. Norway, if we declare war, would Sweden join the war? Yes, they would, which is quite appealing. Especially, oh, I just cannot see the Danish army. But we can just blockade their fleet indefinitely anyway, so... And then keep them on their capital, and then Sweden can do their own stuff. It's good that they're independent. But then again, there's Lithuania and Poland, which is also scary, so... How about you guys? Neutral attitude, distance... Wow, the distance is not helping. And our army strength is low. Maybe we should... Yeah, that's a good idea. Just start increasing our army size a bit. Look! Inflation is down to zero. I do like that one. Gained the colonial con... Wait, what? We've gained the... What? Against the... Oh, against Ottawa. I'm like, wait, what? Because this is the province of Ottawa. This is the nation of Ottawa. Who's supposed to be in Ottawa, but... So, hang on. So I can go to war with them for show superiority. I can annex them and everything. Allied with the Huron and Susquehannock. Oh, sure. Ooh, great league. Great Scott. We might... Nope, we're losing them. We're definitely losing them. Yep, we just lost a few ships. Oh, did we? Oh, we also lost the Explorer. Oh... Yeah, let's leave the tariffs on fish right now. We also lost the Explorer. No. Well, that sucks. I'm going to have to rebuild my ships. How is the colonist do? I think I can just pull back the colonist. I mean, the colony will be growing, and the only thing it's doing is just... increasing this by 1% chance. So let's recall the colonist. That also allows the natives to rise up. And just send them back into Mohawk then. I mean... Wait. Too far away? Say what? That's a little bit annoying. So we don't have naval access right now? Oh my, because suddenly this counted from ports. But... Wait, what? Why? Colony range of... Oh, because it's already colonizing. Damn it, so I have a free... Oh, that's actually very nice to get 100 free pop in that colony there. Religious civil disorder in Sweden. How is Norway doing? Personal union continues. Good support independence. Grain in the grain coast. Colony surprised. Yeah, what's this? That's Sweden. Yeah, they would join the war. We are not allied right now. Why? I don't know. Palatinate again. So let's offer the alliance again. Bit odd that they were suddenly not. Maybe because they changed religion to... they changed to Protestant. That's okay. It's actually fine for now. Back to you. Moscow. How much is our relation? 91. That's actually pretty damn good. Competing great powers. Lithuanian opinion. Distance borders. Aragon took some land from Castile. Happens often in the games I play, at least. They would not accept an alliance. Ah, neutral towards me, though. That's sad. How about Bohemia? They would offer... I want an alliance with Bohemia. Are you currently at war? Don't seem to be. Yes, active cardinal. Great Britain. Nice. Don't have to spend anything in him anymore. On him, whatever. Yeah, I have to tone down on the amount of colonies I have, apparently. Otherwise, it's going to suck. Yeah, we're just getting this one done here, and then we're just going to do North America. Damn it, I lost... I need a cord province up here. Oh, yes. Okay, let's get you back. Is anyone producing... France is trying to take over Howard. Well, that's not going to happen. How's the temples? 1.05, 1.38 actually there. Constables, 1.40. 1.40 in Lothian as well. And I do would like a... I need to save for ships. I can still have more... The Bohemian army is extremely small right now. Yeah, probably because they were at war with the others. We can have centralization. Yeah. How far is the next one? Quite far, so let's do centralization. Another advisor if possible. Good for us. Bill of Rights, less revolt risk. Where is the revolt risk? Wessex, religious revolt risk. That's okay. Sweden. Ah yes, it's trying to convert itself into Protestantism, I suppose. Mm-hmm. I need the Orkneys at one point, though. But this is just... support independence. Let's just support independence of Norway. Even though they're distrusting us. I wonder how they would do it. How that would happen, though. Also, a good way to start that would be to covert action support rebels. Gotlander nationalists, Catholic zealots. First get Gotland away from them. Oh, that would be nice. Okay, time for a Carrick. Can afford one. Yeah, I'm gonna need more of the shipbuilding buildings. Which are in diplomatic tech, of course. The next one is actually at the next level. Naval force limit plus one. Norway... Yep, perhaps a policy change. Not gonna lose 100 diplomatic power just because of Norway. No, that's not good. Not Norway, no. No, no, no. Yes. Now we know of Ottawa. There are probably quite a few natives around there. 5 base tax, 4, 3, 3.24. Wow, that's oddly specific base tax. 5.18, sorry. Still doing decent. Well, I guess I can just send him back then, actually. Should have done that earlier. Declaration of Indulgence is still the same. Good news, more naval supplies. Yay. France is big and scary. Should just get wiped out. Ah, Bohemia is rebuilding. That's good. So Denmark is allied with Mecklenburg, Bohemia. The Cardinal is no longer loyal to us, but we have 16 points to spend. France is gaining on us on Howard, so we're going to spend there as well. I keep clicking it. Interesting, but no. Denmark, do you have any vassals? Or are you just... Yes, Holstein is your vassal. Artis died? Oh no, that's admin. Plus one tax modifier, that's actually not bad. Unhappiness among the clergy. Ignore their demands. Right now, not that important to get the papal influence up higher. You know what, let's make the 13 colonies love us a bit more. Improve relations. Portugal needs one more after Onondaga. Hopefully they go for Muscogee, but... Wyandotte does have more base tax, so you might not know. But then again, I don't mind giving them Wyandotte at all. No. I'm actually going to wait. I want to build a ship first. And only then we shall increase our admin power income again. Muscovy should be able to reform into... Russia. 6 for 6. He is an administrator. Militarist. Denmark also. Yeah, it's the same guy, of course. Duh. If we were to declare war, Bohemia, they are allied to the enemy. To tradition, declare war on Bohemia would not join the war. Sweden would join that war, though. Subject to Denmark, which will protect them. That's these allies, of course. Building. Well, we can build a regular building. A temple or some. Constables. Temple would be... Colonial company goes bankrupt. Ooh. Population of settlers in Saskatchewan changed by 50%. One of the colonial ventures has run into serious financial trouble. If no action is taken, the colonists could suffer. How does the speed of 78 every year? Time for us to step in. Definitely step in on that one. Green Coast, how are you doing? 5.5% now chance on settlers, so it should start increasing a little bit faster now. Which is good, good. Free leader. We have a claim on Orkney, which I would really like to get. Can I just ask them to sell it to us or something? Sell province. No, I can only sell to them. They would have to sell to me. Ungrateful natives of Mohawk have risen again. Two cardinals change loyalty at the same time. Ah, France is pushing it. I want the one with the platinum back first. Okay, so we have our Carrick here. 18 heavies, 18 transports. And an army of 18, exactly, so that's good. And we have some more armies, of course, but still, it's good. Damn it. Lithuania, Poland. Needs to be a huge war between Lithuania, Poland, Austria, and Bohemia, maybe. That's... Governor dies again. George Cromwell. Now we'll send in another diplomat candidate because, well, that's how it goes. And different name again. Yeah, there must be something wrong with how that is triggered if he continuously gets a different name. Ideas. Naval glory, prestige from naval battles, that's good. Force limits, tradition, maneuver, blockade, ship costs. Ah, oh, need it. Nationalistic enthusiasm, land maintenance goes down. Yeah, our fleet maintenance is a lot worse though. Because so many ships. We have actually got 50 out of our 80 total maxed. Oh, I keep forgetting, we're trying to rebuild an army. Because that's our mission. We should just complete our mission and get new missions. 75 of force limit. We need out of 47, let's say 48, so 36. We need 7 more units. Let's first get another cavalry unit. Need to keep it a little bit more balanced. Yeah, I really need to go back to a single colony as well, though, just for the income. 6 here, 10 here. Whew, good armies. Well, that's also a reason why we need a bigger army, of course. Because that's going to be painful if they decide that our weakness is the reason they will revolt. So, yeah. That's fine, though. Yeah, we could tell them, hey, give me more money, but not preferably. Norway still going to continue. Not helpful. You know what? I'm gonna do something that will increase my income a little bit, and that is turning the Welsh provinces into English provinces. There we go. It costs us diplomatic power, I know. Could also at one point... No! Scottish is actually all British culture feel... Yes! So we don't have to change the Scottish culture, that's good. The Welsh, of course, we need to change. Here we go, we got them back again. Oh my, we have a lot of room, by the way, for our missionaries, well, our diplomats to be working. No one is allied to the Pope for some reason. Might be a good reason, though. Competing great power, of course you're competing great power. Wouldn't expect anything less from France. Hire a military leader, I know I can. So I'm gonna hire an admiral. Oh, it costs diplomatic power. It's painful. I'm gonna need him for a war with Denmark, though, of course. Green coasts. Let's improve relations with Hungary. And we are actually at a diplomat limit again. 9% chance now, that's good. What popped up actually? I think it was soft casualties, yeah. Treasury is actually increasing, so one less colony would be good for us. Then this will drop by a lot. Army maintenance, naval maintenance, fleet maintenance, yeah, but we're gonna need them ships all along. 22, so how is our trade power now in the node? 1.78 only, really, is that it? Everything's pulled forward, mostly by me. Oh, whoa. You know what, I want the prestige from that one. I'm gonna need my merchants as well. Wow. Colonial discovery. Our colonists have stumbled upon an amazing discovery in the New World, and it is a real delicacy back in Europe. The major trading houses are importing this curiosity by the barrel load. They have discovered enough to supply your kingdom. I actually read Klingon the first time. I don't know why, but I did. Sire. Until the end of time. Nice. With what this is, I wanted to get diplo power. Pressure's back. Yeah. The money's... Oh, Newfoundland is pushing all trade power into... Wow. Into a Gulf of St. Lawrence node, actually. Interesting. And there's a lot going out of this node, though. There's not a lot of money coming into this node any longer. So actually what I'm going to do is send him to the North Sea node. Transfer trade power. You are going to transfer it. And you guys are going to go to London and patrol that node then. Because it's going to be a lot better. Lost trade dispute. Yeah, I get it. Not that much money. Retained value, incoming zero. Lost effects of trading, that's fine. You are in Essex. I want you in London. Okay, trade in the North Sea. More and more money. Wow. There we go. A lot more money going downstream to me. So that's good. And this way we will bypass this entire node where it's a little bit more competition than I would like. And that's why I would like to change this loyalty to France and we get you back. So how much is our trade income now? 14.91. Yes, it has increased. This is also a good reason to build markets now in the Scotland area. Because that will increase our trade power here as well. Because of North Sea. Also, constable, still good money. But I think we need more ships. I'm the only one pulling trade away, and it's pulling most of the trade away because our trade power is just so enormous in this node. First merchant we're going to send, of course, to the Gulf of St. Lawrence and push trade to the North Sea. Ungrateful natives arrived home from the Pope. They actually are building up fleets as well. Nice. This is going to be fun. I hope Portugal expands into a colonial territory there as well. I'm going to build... Right, I need more army. So I'm going to build two of these. I'm going to build them here just to save that bit more money. 9 income now, even though we... One less colony and that income will go through the roof. And that's what I need. Ungrateful natives, that's fine. Morgan and Saskatchewan are both very close, actually. That's good. Because more money means I can support a bigger force as on land as well as on the water. Suffolk has arrived. Platnet has taken over once again. Need one more. France has got 75 as well, though. Ottomans, you know what? Let's improve relations. Castile, let's improve relations. Let's be happy together. Portugal, you're an ass. So, yes, France took it back already. I'll definitely increase in Muscovy. Yeah, the thing is, as soon as... Hang on, what is Austria doing? They're at war with Lithuania. Lithuania is at war with Poland, Riga, Livonian Order. Oh, that's good for us. Norway is at war with Lithuania. I need one of my diplomats back. Improved by 8, improved by 56, improved by... Yeah, come back, you. And this might be the time, because they're busy in a war. Maybe the Danish forces are also stuck there. No, there are ships sieging over there. Just fine. Invest in an idea, and I will take it. Land maintenance goes down, which is good. You guys, I'm going to need you to go to the... Actually, I don't need everything, so I'm going to just... I believe it's just going to be a level 2 fortress, isn't it? Yes. So what I'm going to split off is... Not... I didn't want to do that. I need to press this one. New unit, 2 infantry, and our only cannon. You're going to go into the highlands to basically do that. Invest in a cardinal. I think this one is first. We can build more stuff, so more units. I want a cavalry unit. Yes, I can build 2 cavalry units. So I'm going to do it. There we go. That's our cavalry increasing. Almost done with both of these, actually. Which is good. Our fleet. We're going to need a good admiral. So, yeah, he's not that good, but still, it's an admiral. I'm going to send him first here, just to secure that we can cross into the Orkneys without an issue. And Denmark, how are you doing? Diplomacy, you are at war, so are you. Sweden has a decent sized force now, so if we declared war, Poland, Bohemia, Brandenburg, and Mecklenburg, but Lithuania, yeah, they have forces, but they're not that many. And I don't need that big of a war, actually, to take what I want. Oh, third in score, actually, that's good. Also, our colonies will help us as well. If possible, I want to gain the Shetlands as well. So actually, what I'm going to do is pull you back for a second. No, actually, I don't. I just want to get... There's also... Shetlands is also... 2, yes, also 2. So I'm going to send in 4 more of you. I'm going to push you into Aberdeen. Because then we can get both the Faroes as well as the Shetlands. And at one point as well, them. Let's check on their army. I actually need to do this. Army. So Norway army is 10,000 strong. They would need to land first, which is good. Denmark has an army. So if we declared war on them, take Orkney. Aggressive expansion, call allies. Sweden says yes, Bohemia says no. That's fine though. Let's first wait that at least one more colony is done. So that would be helpful. And trade embargo, platinum refusing merchants of Austria. Reformation in Foix. Interesting, so Foix gets the first reformation. That's here. Okay, so the reformation has started. Might also be useful if it spreads to us. I would like that. Because it would give us trade power. No, London. Smartass. Saskatchewan, self-sustaining. Really good. You're going into Nipigon and send in the colonists. Mohawk is almost done as well. I'm going to leave these forces here for now. Because they're going to go Tuskegee or Oneida. Does it? Oneida has no sea access, actually. Colony self-sustaining also goes to... Wow, prestige from colonies. Hell yes. Now we're making lots of money again. Haha. That's good for us. So let's start building. I want a dock somewhere. Now we're getting docks everywhere at one point, but... For now, let's build a Constable and Lothian. Okay, we're almost ready for a war that will, well, be quite interesting, to say the least. Have they? They're still at war. Lithuania is actually winning the war as well. Marienburg occupied by Denmark. Is Marienburg the capital of Lithuania? No, it's the target of the war. But Poland defender against Poland-Lithuanian Regan trade war. Huh. Ah, so everyone came to the help of Riga. Okay. Anyway, I guess this is it for this episode. And here we go. Boom. Red War. And apparently here we have a fleet fighting another fleet, which is good. Actually, I'm going to send in this fleet just to be a dick. At the same time, we can advance you onto the Orkneys. Red War, guys, and for a good reason, we'll control the entirety of the British Isles. I want to thank you all for watching. I will see you guys later.